How's it going, Transformers fans? How's it going, YouTube? This is Mitch Santona back with a review. This is a review slash video response to the five awesome Transformers guys. The response is, what is your worst toy? Your worst Transformers toy? And before you, I've got a myriad of real crap bombs, to put it mildly. And I'll go through it really quick, and I just want to defend and explain. These two guys, while not bad in robot mode, their alt modes are absolutely horrendous. This is garbage. Purely garbage. And these are recent toys. I mean, this thing is just bad. All the way around, bad. The wheels look bad. They're not even, they're like inboard. They're not even set in the right spot. There is no window in the back. These windows are painted some color that's just horrific looking. And it looks like a frickin' jigsaw puzzle. It feels cheap. This is a terrible, terrible, terrible alt mode. Both of these are, they should be ashamed of themselves for these. These are terrible. Now, the robot modes look kind of decent, so that's why they're just runner-ups. Unfortunately, this guy, again, an Ironhide, another Ironhide. This is a Generation 1 Ironhide. I remember watching the cartoon and saying, this guy is one of my favorite characters. I need to get Ironhide. He was a badass. He was a badass in the cartoon. Didn't take crap from anybody. Always sticking up for Optimus, wanting to scrap, wanting to fight, threatening to putting liquid nitrogen in someone's eyes and all that. I mean, just, he was cool, man. And then I got this character, and even this toy, and even in 1984, this thing sucked. The robot mode on this thing is terrible. And this is a freaking minivan. That's not exciting. How is this exciting to play with? Even as a kid. Even when the novelty of this was new. This is still not good. I was so disappointed. Ironhide, incidentally, is one of my favorite characters. And I'll defend Ironhide because, well, he's Ironhide. But, God, those toys are bad. This thing, I talked about him in an earlier review. This is just a piece of junk. Look, I put the thing back in the box normally. And where is that? Where did the fourth thing go? It just popped off. God, but sorry, can't stand him. And this is just atrocious. By the way, that was Blazemaster, Revenge of the Fallen, and another Revenge of the Fallen atrocity. And let me tell you something. Mixmaster, the Voyager-class Mixmaster, is not far behind. It's cool. Let me put it this way. That thing is awesome in both cement mixer mode and robot mode. But getting them between, gosh, I want to take a sledgehammer to that thing so bad. It was like an all-afternoon ordeal. Instructions out, watching PR's video on how to do it right. It's just bad. And this thing's a piece of junk, too. I'm not gonna sugarcoat that at all. But this is not the review. This is not what I'm doing. Those were runners-up. This is almost too easy for me, this question. And it's almost, and I'm so shocked that no one's even said it, because one of the things I have a problem with is, well, like I said about Ironhide, I can defend Ironhide because he's got a great character, but this guy that I'm going to show you right now, my worst toy of all of my toys, also has one of the worst characters in Transformers history. Like I said, this is almost too easy. I mean, come on, really? This is for real. This is a for real thing. What is this? It looks like one of those grubs that Survivor Man pulls out of one of those Australian trees. I mean, what is this thing? It looks terrible. And this is the good part, and you're looking at its best mode. Generation 1 Wheelie. Now, the only reason I own this stupid looking toy is because he came free with Cup when I bought the reissue of Cup. Other than that, I don't know why I don't just throw them out. Character on this guy. Let's go with my text back here. See it in the corner? That's a zero. I give this guy a zero. He is the worst, most annoying, stupid character of all time. This guy infuriates me. His voice, his stupid rhymes, I absolutely hate it. I hated Wheelie in the cartoons. It drove me bananas. The mold on this, I give it a one. I mean, the alt mode is a futuristic car.
I guess. I don't know. It looks bad. Sure. The paint. Okay, his paint's not bad. I mean, it's not good. I give it a 6. It probably would have been better if it wasn't this Allspark blue, which that may just be in the re-release, because I don't recall the original being this. But these two oranges kind of work well together with the gray, so that's not too bad, but that blue is pretty hideous, so he loses points for that. Alt mode on this guy, I give it about a 5. It's very average at best, and it's the best mode for this. Transformation, I give a 2-2. Here it is. Ready? He's stuck. Come on. You open this stupid thing, and then you pull the feet out, or down, or whatever. You do this a little bit. Pull it out. There he is. Attaboy. There we go. Come on. Oh, he's not. See, his freaking head is stuck now. Oh, for the love of... See, this just infuriates me even more. Now the stupid hood, this visor thing is going to get stuck. There. That's wheelie. Isn't that fun? Isn't that a fun time? Good times. Great times. That's for real. This is a for real toy. Even in 1987, 1985, whenever the heck this thing came out, this thing sucked. Sorry. Transformation, I give a 2-2. That's stupid and lame. Robot mode, I give a 1-2 because this is absolutely ridiculous looking. And up until just 2 seconds ago, I didn't know he had individual articulation in his legs. And look at how splendid that looks. Huh? Wow, that looks like action-packed here. Here's his posability. Doesn't that look cool? He looks like Mr. Game & Watch. What is this thing? So robot mode, I give a 1-2. Articulation, I guess he's got more than a 3. I gave him a 3 before, but up until, like I said, 2 seconds ago, I didn't even bother to see if he had individual leg articulation. Maybe that's an add-on in his reissue. Maybe they separated these feet or something. I don't know. I don't really care. Quality control, hey, I give it an 8. Not bad. I mean, besides this thing not wanting to stay open, which is the head reveal, not bad. And overall rating, I give this guy a 1. I say, don't ever, just don't buy this. This is ridiculous. Let me zoom into the face, too. This is the most infuriating thing here. Let me see if I can zoom into the face. Come on, Wheelie. Zoom in, baby. I'm gonna stop it and see if I can get a good shot of this ridiculous-looking face.
Okay, there's a close-up of this dude's face. Now, that doesn't look anything like a robot to me. Does it look like one to you? It looks like one of the Blue Man Group or something, only painted gray and stuck inside of an orange shell of a... This is so freaking terrible. I hate this thing. So overall, I don't recommend this. Don't go out of your way to get this unless you're a completist. There's no purpose of getting this at all. If it comes free with something, consider selling it. I got mine with Cup. Cup was worth it. He's solid. And I can't wait for the reissue. But this guy is absolutely terrible. So I know it's kind of an easy target because this guy's just all around a bad, bad character. But I think this is my worst toy in my whole collection. I really hate it. And this has been Mitch Santona with a huge thumbs down on Wheelie.